Let us start the last class. Let us start. Now, we are discussing the shear force and bending moment diagram. Now, we have not understood that we have discussed that there are different type of loading in a beam, which is defined as a particular prismatic bar, which is subjected to a load, so load normal to its longitudinal axis. And this longitudinal load along the longitudinal axis can be of different type. Different types of loading means that can be an independent point load in an independent, in a particular point, or it can be a one single in number, it can be more than one in number. There can be distributed load that is, which is being distributed over a certain place over the beam. It can be totally distributed from the whole length. It can be partly distributed. The distribution, rate of distribution of the load can be uniform throughout the length. Also, it can vary from point to point. And the beam is another method, another idea of the beam is that how it is supported. It can be supported by a roller support at its end, or it can be supported by hinge support at its end. Also, it can be supported by embedding it in the wall, by keeping the other side free, or keeping the other, some of the support on the other side, on the free side. Now we are discussing this type of beams, which is embedded in the wall, which is defined as or termed as cantilever beam. And we are using this type of support, that is cantilever beam support, and by exerting it to different type of loading, like say, distributed load or independent point load. Now we are discussing a method which where it is load is distributed up to a certain length, but not the full length, and the independent point loads are available. That's what's more in number, actually, four in number at different known positions of the length throughout the length of the beam. And we are supposed to calculate, we have to make the shear force diagram and bending moment diagram of the beam, which means we want to know what is the magnitude of the separate shear forces at different portion of the beam, and what is the magnitude of the bending moment at its different portion of the beam. So in this type of beam, the shear force here, it is loaded like this. It is a cantilever because it is embedded in one end, that is left end of the beam, and it is hanging throughout this length, and it has no other support but the cantilever support. Now, it carries the independent part point load on 6, 4, 6, and 4, total 20 kilonewton load in different points of the beam. Some at the point B, 6 is at B, another 4 at C, another 4 at 6, and another 4 at 4. And the distance from this point of application is known. This is from the support, that is from the cantilever support. The distance of individual point of application is known. That is, point B is 2 meters away from the end support A. Point C is 2 plus 2, 4 meters away. Point D is 2 plus 2, 4 plus 3, 7 meters away. And point G, it is 2 plus 2, 4 plus 3, 7 plus 3, 10 plus 4, 14 meters away from the end A. And other than this independent point load, this beam is subjected to a distributed load, distributed from the point C and to the point E, and but not the full length of the beam, and rate of distribution is uniform. It is 2 kilonewton per meter. Now, we are supposed to, and respectively for the length, we are supposed to draw the shear force and bending moment diagram. That is our problem. In order to know the shear force and bending moment diagram, we have to know the shear force in the individual section. Here we have to take the section between E and G, that is here, at here, at here, at here, and at here respectively. So if we take the individual section, we'll find out the shear force and bending moment on this individual section. Now, let us work for the shear force first. The point EG, that is the point between, this is the bending moment here, point EG, where the, what we are, I'm imagining that we are considering the shear force at the right of the section, from this section to the up to the point G, which means this point, this is at a distance X from the from the end G. Now, if we take the section, we'll know that shear force, where there will be only one shear force is acting here. That is, if the section is like this, the load is acting here, and shear force acting is like this, in the upward, as per our conventional orientation of shear force. Now, as it is for Kn constant, there is not the load on the beam, so this Px will be equal to this 4A. And as this Vx is constant, it is to extend up to the point E to the beam, up to the point E of the beam. And what will be the position of Dx? What is the next position? We'll consider that next section is at between DE and X is. So here loading will be like this. That is the load at O, that is G. That is the load at E, that is E, that is no other load, and that is the load at between the section and the G. The section at a distance X from the G, and E is at a distance 4 meters from G. So this distance is X minus 4 distance, X minus 4 meters. That is from here to up to the point E. So the load acting over it, first of all, this is the load, one load is acting over it, and another load is acting 4 Kn, and here X minus 4 multiplied by the rate of loading, that is 2 Kn. So here the load will be X minus 4 multiplied by 2 Kn. And there is a shear force acting over this direction, in the opposite direction. So this Vx is valid from between 2 into X plus 4, 2 into X minus 4 plus 4 Kn. That is, that becomes 2X minus 8 plus 4. That is 2X minus 4 Kn. So this is the direction. But here it is changing from the distance X. And so it will take this particular shape here, but it is a varying. And at the point when X is equal to 4, it will be equal to 4 Kn at the point D, and when X is equal to 7, X is equal to 7, then it becomes, means at the point D, it will become 14 minus 4, that is equal to 10 Kn. So here we are seeing that this 10 Kn is there. Next, we'll have the portion, the section will go from here between C to D, here the x will be, distance will be x from the end G up to the section taken. So thus what we have, the we will have the loading like this, more or less same, but the loads are different. 4kN up to the point G to the point X, that is E. This is 4, and this end is from here to here is X. Thus, the loading here from X minus, here is also load is here, X minus 4. It is also distance X minus 4. Okay. So similarly, the Vx will be the shear force, and the loading will be again 2 into X minus 4. So Vx will be is equal to 2 into X minus 4 plus 4K. Now, the loading will is being varying here, and at the point 10, what we found, this at the point 10, it was 10. And but it is happens that is 6 here, it is 6 plus 6. There is another load at the point T. Here is another center load at the point T. So it's a diagram is not right. Let me do it again. So this is the bar. It is G, it is E, it is D, and this is the section here. That is 4 and 4kN. That is T is 6kN. And from here, loading is there. This distance is X from D to T, 3kN meter. And from here, it is X. Up to the section, it is X. So X minus 4 multiplied by 2kN. Another force, 2kN minus X minus 4. So what we have? The vertical force Vx is here. So Vx equal to 2 into X minus 4 plus 6kN plus 4kN, that goes up to 2x plus 8, 2x minus 8 plus 10, that is 2x minus 2 plus 2. Now here, what we put the value of x equal to, say, 7. Then what will happen if x is equal to 7? Means at this point t, 3 plus 4 is equal to 7, so it is 14. Plus 2, it is 60. So here the load is changing to up to 60. And load is varying, and it will become at the point C, where X is equal to C, at C, where X is equal to 3 plus 3, 6 plus 3 plus 3 is equal to 6 plus 4 is equal to 10. So there, C plus V is equal to T, that is 10. That is, X will be equal to 20 plus 2. Vx at X equal to 10, this will become, interesting choice, 20 plus 2, 22. So this is here, the load is here, changing up to 22. Next, again, we will draw the section here, somewhere here. Let us do it. Now let us section here. It is will be x. Now what will happen? Here we'll have the bar section of the bar is like this. That is 4 kN from up to this. That is 4 meter from here to here. That is 6 plus 6. That is total 6. That is 12 6. That is also 1 6 here. 6 kN. Again, that is another 6 here. 4 here, in fact, not 6. 4 kN. And total distance is equal to x. So what is going on here? Px will be equal to. That is total. This real distance is 3 plus 3, that is 6. So Vx will be 6 into 2. There is no x. Vx is 6 into 2. 6 into 2. And plus there will be 4 kN. This 4 kN, 6 kN, and another 4 kN means 4 plus 6 plus 4. That is, which is equal to 12 plus 4 plus 6 plus 4, that is 16. So, 16 plus 6, 22 plus 4, 26. So, here the load after the point G here, it becomes 26. And similarly, if we take the section here, it will add another load with it. That is 6 kN will add to it, like another 6. So, this will become 6 plus 6 is equal to 32. So this is the distribution of shear stress starting from 4, it is varying up to 10, then it is improved up to 16, then again varied up to 22, then again fixed up to 26, then again increased and fixed up to 32. So what is going on is now the bending moment. The bending moment diagram. So bending moment, first the portion EG, that is the portion here, where it is loaded by 4 kN and it is loaded by clockwise direction MX at the end E. So this is X. So this is loaded with positive and both are positive in nature. So Mx will be equal to 4x. And M at the point 4x and M at the point C is equal to at the point say at the point E and ME 6 into 4. That is 24. 0.4 4 into 4, 4 into 36, that is 4 kN, 4 into 4, 16 kN. Next, at the point TX again, this is like this. This is 4, 4 kN. এখানে কিছু আছে না 4 kN and from the point T it is loaded like this that is X and this is 4 this is 4 so the distance are like this here the torque is mx and here x minus 4 and 2 kN is the loading universally 2 kN into x minus 4 2 into x minus 4 is the loading is acting at a distance half of the flow distance x minus 4 so this distance is x minus 4 by 2 thus mx will be here you see mx is there 4 is equal to 4 into x mx 4 into x plus 2 into 2 into x minus 4 whole square by 2. Similarly here portion CD is 4x again and thus MD is if you put the value of x is equal to here x equal to 3 plus 4 7 md will become 27 md will become 37 and again if we put at the portion cd if we take the section here at the portion cd it will this will add another this 6 kilonewton force will act and this line of action of this force x minus 7 so this is that these two bending moments are all there plus x minus 7 6 into x minus 7 is added and thus if we put the value of x equal to from x is equal to 7 3 plus 4 4 plus 4, 8. 4 plus 4, 8. That will become, x is equal to 10, they are saying. 7 is 37 already we have. And 7, no, this is 10, not 7, but 10. That this will become 94 K. Similarly, at the portion BC, another 4, x minus 10 will add it. But these two others are remain same, and x minus 4 is added, and 2 into x minus 7 plus x minus 4. That is 94 for the point C and 146 at the point K. So it is at acting clockwise direction in the left of the section. So it is defined as negative, and it is taken plotted like this. Which is varying from 0 at this end and to 210 at this end. Just 1 second, please. Now, Next question is shear force or bending moment diagram for simply supported beam. A simply supported beam may carry concentrated or uniformly distributed load. What we have told that what is simply supported? It can be like this. This is just a beam. It can be supported at the bend and roller support. It can be supported at the end by hinge support. And it can be loaded like this here. Or it can be distributed like this. Now, assume a simply supported beam of leg L carrying a concentrated load W at a distance A from end A. Say, let the distance CB be B. So this is the length of the beam from A to B. A concentrated load is acting at A at a distance, say A at end of left end and at B and right end. Now, first it is required to find the reactions in the support. First, we have to find out here the taking total moment at the end A. We are taking the moment at the end A. Then the reaction at the support here at B multiplied by L is equal to minus W multiplied by A. So RB will become RA WB by L. The shear force diagram, the portion BC, consider the section at a distance X from the foot end B. The force at the right of the section is RB. Consider section shear force diagram. Now we take a section at the port at a distance end A. The force, the right of the section is RB and upwards and constant along the length up to the point C. So shear force will be negative and the shear force diagram is a horizontal straight line as in figure B. Here it is opposite side because if you take the shear force is acting over the beam with the upward side at the right side, so it is supposed to be negative. It is given as negative itself. Next, the shear force at the section X at the portion B here, which is RB minus W here, by plus RB minus W, WA by L minus W, WA minus W divided by L is equal to W to L minus A by L is equal to RA. Now the shear force will be positive and the shear force diagram is a horizontal straight line as in figure. Now the portion AB can also be taken first and the force at the left of any section can be considered. So in case the portion at the left is RA and upwards and D and the shear force positive, that is the same as before. The bending moment diagram. Now consider distance X here again in a similar way at the end P. So taking the moment RB into X, where RB is equal to W into A into X divided by L. So MB is equal to at X is equal to 0, then MB is equal to 0, then C is equal to where X is equal to B, WA into P divided by L. At the motion portion to the right of the section is counterclockwise. As the moment on the right of the section of the beam is counterclockwise, the bending moment is positive. This the bending moment also has a observing as sagging and thus positive. Therefore, the bending moment is linear and increases with the value of X. So it is the maximum at WAB by L and it is reaches the maximum at 1 and then comes back to the 0 again. Now, a portion consider section at a distance X from the distance A. Again, RA into X, WBX by L, that is MA at where x is equal to L, and MA is equal to 0, and MB and MC is equal to WL into P. The moment to the left of the section is clockwise, the bending moment is positive, the bending moment also can also be observed as sagging and thus positive. If the load is at the middle span, at A is equal to B L by 2, thus the bending moment at middle span is the maximum at WL divided by 4, which is the maximum for any position of the pilot on the beam. Next, the uniformly distributed load like this. This is the simply supported beam supported at both the ends and uniformly distributed a load of distance of distribution W or omega mu per unit length is given here. So W into X into RB, RA into RB equal to RB W into L by 2. The section at a distance X from A, Fx is equal to RA minus R2X. RA minus W is equal to WL by 2 minus WX. That is equal to W into L by 2 minus X. Say here, at a distance X from A, from somewhere here. We are taking the distance from here at a distance X from A. So reaction will be RA plus RB equal to WL by 2. It is divided like this. And at a distance X from A, say this is the X here. RA minus WX, RA is WL by 2 minus WX. And WL by 2 minus X linear. If FA is a W into L by 2, FB W into L by 2. FB X equal to 0, then it will become WL by 2 and XB X prime equal to L is minus WL by 2. So it is changing from, shear stress is changing from WL by 2 here positive and changing to minus WL by 2 here as negative. The bending moment at this section. Bending moment at this section is found by treating the distributed load acting at its center of gravity. MA, MX equal to RA into X. So here if we take the bending moment in RA, the distance is from X, take the bending moment from this section like this. Just 1 second.
Hello.
A bending moment at a section is found by treating.
Okay.
Now, Mx is equal to RA into X, RA into WX, WX into X by L, RA into X minus W into X by L. So, RA is here, RA multiplied by X, and W into X is the total length of the four distributed force divided by the distance X by 2. And this is acting clockwise, this is acting anticlockwise, so they are of different time. And Mx plus, so that is WL by 2 X minus 2. This is parallel. At X, M is equal to A, X is equal to 0, and at B, X is equal to L, equal to 0. So the maximum value F, Tm by Dx is equal to 0, thus, or WL by 2 minus WX is equal to 0, or X is equal to L by 0. L by 2. So maximum bending moment, if we put L X equal to L by 2, is equal to W L squared by 8. Now, the bending moment A ship is opposite beam.
Here, the support, okay.
Carries a point load. Of 8 meter length, 2 plus 3, 5 plus 1, 6 plus 2, 8N. Carries point loads, 8N, 4N, 10K. Add 2 from A here, 2 plus 3 here, and 1 here, and 2 meter here. Yes, certainly for the LN. So here it is 2 meter from left end, 2 plus 3, 5 at of the left end, plus 1, 6 from the left end, plus 2, and reaction is at 8K. So first of all, we have to calculate the reaction. The RB is equal to RB into 10, which is equal to 8 into 2, 8 multiplied by 2 plus 4 multiplied by 2 plus 3, 5, 5, and 10 multiplied by 2 plus 3 plus 1, 6. So RB is equal to 10 plus, thus RB become equal to 12 kN. Because it is, you have to write down that is 16 plus 20 plus 60, that is 80 plus 96, 96 divided by 8, that is 12K. And RA has become again 10K. In shear force diagram, the shear force diagram will be here. FX, the distance here, that is equal to 10 kN constant. Okay. How? This is 12 on this side, 12 on the upper side, and at a distance, nothing. 12, no, RA is 10. 10 kN and 12 kN. 12 kN, now, Fx is equal to, if we take this section somewhere here, then the Vx will be 10K. Because there's only another force Tx. If we take this section at somewhere here, that is, it is opposite 10 minus 8K, that is 2K, that is positive, which is equal to 2K. So here, up to this C, it's 10, and after C, it's 2K. The portion D, this is 2, and it is in opposite direction, that is minus 4, that is 4K. So here we'll have 10K and 1 positive, 8K and 1 negative, another 4K downwards. This is downwards, downwards, and upwards. So it becomes plus 12K downwards. So it is taken 12 minus 10, this 2K downwards. Okay. At the point E, at the point E, it has become Fx minus 10 into 15, that is EB. Here we have 10 upwards, 8 minus 8 downwards, 4 downwards, and another 10 downwards, that is minus 12. So here it is as negative minus 12 downwards. Similarly, bending moment, become 10x, here we take the calculation, that is 10x at a distance x from the end A, and there is only one force is there, this couple you have to consider 10 into x, that is 10a. And MA is equal to x equal to 0 is equal to 0, and x is equal to MC, x is equal to 2 is equal to 20. So, but if you put x equal to 2, it is 10 into x, 20, and f is equal to 0, it is 0, that is mx equal to 0. At CD, 10x minus 8, x minus 2, and it's 10, this distance is 2, so if you put the value x here, x minus 2 will be the distance of line of movement.